Good afternoon. I'm Ted Low. I'm the Department Business Manager here in the Ming Hsieh Department of Electrical Engineering. And I've had the privilege of working with Mr. Boston, this wonderful man that we're honoring today. Welcome to everyone. Thank you for coming. And even those who are on the webcast right now. And so we are here to celebrate Tim's life, to honor him, to laugh a little, cry a little, and share what he has meant to us as a friend and colleague. Tim's family is here joining us today. Tim's wife, Minda. Tim's oldest son, Nick, who is joining us via webcast in London. Tim's son, Mark, and Tim's daughter, Sarah, and the rest of the family. So to start things off, I'd like to introduce our current department chair of Electrical Engineering Systems, Professor Sandeep Gupta.
Hello, everyone. Welcome. I was trying to think about, you know, we were just talking about how long Tim had been a part of the department. I mean, he was part of the department for as long as one can remember, but the reality is that when I first came to USC a little over 26 years ago, he was in the dean's office, and I did meet with him because he is the one who told me all about benefits and how to sign up for benefits. So that was the first time I met him about 27 years ago. But then he moved to the department sometime along the way, and he became a part of the family. And when I think about that, one of the things that I wanted to share with you was about 3 years ago, he came to me and he was very concerned. And he said, I think there is a student who's trying to take advantage of one of our senior faculty members. I think Ted knows the story. And he was really concerned. He said, this student is very, you know, persistent, and he has bullied this professor into sort of, you know, giving him funding. You know, can you go check upon this? And it fell upon me to go to this professor, check with him if everything was on the up and up. And the student hadn't, in fact, forced himself on this professor and forced him to give him funding. And a few days later, I go back to Tim. I said, you know, Tim, I talked to the professor, and he says, no, this guy has background. You know, he says, he's not even in a department. He's from a different department. I don't see any connection with what he does. And he is basically a kind of a nasty guy, and he's basically just forced himself. And so I talked to the professor, and he assured me that there is a reason, there is a technical reason why this student has joined his group and why he's basically paying him. And Tim said, okay, thank you. And 2 weeks later, again, he's in my office. Said, can you double check this? Because I'm worried about this professor. So he was, you know, this just illustrates how he basically sort of had his, you know, he took care of people around here in many ways. And, you know, the size of this room is, you know, the size of the crowd in this room tells you that he took care of a lot of people. And we'll miss him. I'll miss him. And I'll, more than anything else, miss the 10 o'clock chime, because when I saw Tim with his coffee cup, it was 10 a.m. So I'll ask Sandy Sawchuk, the former chair of the department, to say a few words.
Thanks, Sandy. First, I want to welcome everybody here, and in particular, members of Tim's friends, his friends, his extended family. And I preceded Sandeep as chair, and I was a chair for about 7.5 years, and my term as chair completely overlapped with Tim. And I just will share a few memories of what he had done and what his role in our department was. He is really one of our superb staff members in EP Systems, and he's he had done this for many years. In fact, as Sandeep said, I believe that he's been with EE for about 20 years, and before that, perhaps 9-10 years with the Church of Business Affairs. So I think the result of that is that being here for a while and also being involved with the Viterbi means that he had many associates, many friends from all over the Viterbi school as well as in the university, and it's really wonderful to see so many of you turning out today for that. I think the way I would describe Tim is that he was the ultimate in administrative service. He was friendly, he was cheerful. He had that British aura of what I would say, confidence, credibility, and elegance. And this combination really served him well, and it served our faculty, our staff, and our students well. And the other thought that occurred to me is that he was really our goodwill ambassador. I would say he's probably the first or one of the first staff people, you know, any students coming in would meet. Of course, they would meet with academic advisors and they meet with faculty, but they would also meet with Tim because he had to get them on the payroll, he had to set up their salary, their health insurance, their tuition benefits, and all sorts of other stuff. So he was really an expert at doing that, and he was our international goodwill ambassador. And so this required that of course we have students from all over the world. We have faculty, staff, and students from all over the world. They had many different cultures and many different backgrounds, and Tim was able to relate to that in a very special way. I say that the particular thing that I really credit him for is his expertise on immigration and visas. He knew how to get things done. He knew all the people at the Office of International Students, now I guess it's called Office of International Services. He knew how to get things done, and many, many times students would come to me with a problem, or faculty, they had trouble getting postdoc hired, they had trouble with students entering the country and trying to start their graduate programs, and Tim would figure out a way to get that done. He knew the people at OIS, and sometimes just a visit or a phone call would fix these problems in some magic way that I didn't understand. So he was really very good at that. In addition to all these things, he had other functions. I know he was very involved in the staff assembly. I believe he was an officer in the staff assembly. He was our facilities manager for EE Systems. He was our safety officer, and he was the guy in these earthquake drills. He used to come out with a hard hat. So everybody knew Tim, and they all knew what his role was. I would just say a couple of personal things about him. I always enjoyed talking to him about the British-American parallel universe, what I would call it. And Tim, of course, had his feet in both worlds. And so we would often talk about different names for common everyday objects. And I would just have this banter with him. You know, for example, here are parts of a car in Britain. The boot, the bonnet, and the windscreen. Do you know what those things are? Okay, the boot is the trunk, and the bonnet is what we call the hood, and the windscreen, of course, is the windshield. But I don't know how these different terms evolved. And so I had another one. I always ask them, you go to the UK and you drive on a dual carriageway. Do you know what that's what we would call a divided highway. And there's another thing. When you go to the UK and you want to have a nice dinner at 6 o'clock on Wednesday night, you do not make a reservation. You make a booking. And you have to get the term right. The other thing I always like, in the UK, they do not have exit signs. They have a sign that says "way out." And the other one is, you get into an elevator or something, or you go up the stairs and it says "watch your step here." over there it says mind step. And of course they drive on the left. So stenciled all over cities in the UK on the ground, they have these signs that say, look to the right when you're crossing the street. So these are these British things that I enjoyed talking with him about. And then the other things, of course, were just different ways to pronounce the names of a common object. For example, Tim had a nice British car, and he would call it a Jaguar. We would call it a Jaguar. And then, of course, the field that many of us are involved in, we would call it image processing, but he would call it image processing. And the other thing is, we discussed there's a famous Spanish novelist, Miguel Cervantes, and he wrote a novel that the Spaniards and Americans would call Don Quixote. And of course, in the UK, this comes out as Don Quixote, which I could never quite understand. But anyway, Tim was just a wonderful guy, an inspiration to everybody, to our faculty, our staff, our students. And he's someone that I will personally miss a lot, and I know all of you will too. So we extend our deepest sympathy to his family and his friends.
Thank you, Sandy. I'd like to introduce Sarah, who will come up and say a few words on behalf of the family.
Hi, everyone. Like Ted said, I'm Sarah, and I am Tim's daughter. I apologize in advance if everything kind of comes jumbled. I'm not used to doing this. And my dad's the one that's usually able to string words together, so it sounds nice. But I do want to, first of all, thank you for all being here. It means a lot to us. It's been almost 2 months since we lost my dad, and I don't believe the emptiness will ever go away, but knowing that you guys are here and you're still remembering my dad and keeping his memory alive here at USC, it means the world to us. In any way that you knew my dad, whether you were a student and he was helping you with immigration, you were his colleague, or you were genuinely a friend, he cherished every encounter that he had with all of you, and you're all considered his extended family. He spoke highly about everybody. He talked about how the students were brilliant, and the adversity that a lot of the students overcame to be here at USC. And he spoke about how much he respected all the students being here. His colleagues, he spoke about birthday celebrations, going to lunch, and the friendships that he had over the years of him being here for so long. Those are all things that I believe he took with him and he remembered. About a month before my dad passed away, we went to go see his primary doctor. Even then they were talking, and my dad had mentioned how he was gonna come back to USC at least part-time. And Dr. Sapkins kind of had to bring him back to reality and say, you know, you're probably not gonna come back to go back to work. And that's just a testament to all of you, because at the end of the day, a job is a job, but it's the people that you work with that makes the difference of why he wanted to come back. So I thank you for being there for my dad and for taking care of him while he was here at USC. I speak for my family when we say we're honored that you were his extended family and that we were able to share him with you. Because he spent more time here than he did at home. So we're honored that we were able to share him with you. I just wanted to say for anybody who did donate to the Phelan McDermott Syndrome Foundation or spread the word about it, it was something the cause was very important to my dad, because my brother Nick, who's in London, his youngest son, was born with the syndrome. So it was something that was very important to my dad. So there is no better gift that you could have given him in my dad's memory than to support that cause. So I really appreciate on behalf of my family. So thank you.
Next. now it's part of the program that we all have an opportunity to share stories with Tim. Our lives were blessed by knowing him and having an opportunity to bless others by sharing these stories. But if you're a little shy, you don't have to come up to the mic, but please remember these stories, and even during the reception, please take time to share these stories with each other. I'm going to start off. I'll share a few stories, random memories and thoughts. I remember the first time I met Tim. That was the very first day that I started working here 10 years ago. And after completing my hired paperwork, we chatted, and Tim went on and on about how great EE Systems was and how we are the best department. And you know, after 10 years here, I totally agree with him. In my biased opinion, we really do have the best staff, faculty, and students. And I don't mean to throw any shade on the other departments. As Sandy said, Tim's role in the department was unique and an important one. He was our payroll expert and our immigration guru. And he was often asked by other departments to help out. So he was always helping out various different departments with immigration questions or getting people hired. I remember when Tim won the Dean's Staff Award for Excellence in 2008. He in turn sent an email to the entire staff thanking the staff for the help over the years. And I'll quote, it says, "I could not do my job and therefore have been recognized with the award yesterday without your support. I am therefore delighted to accept the award on behalf of the whole department." In 2009, I also have a note here. I had just come back from vacation, and as soon as I walked in the door, Tim gave me this look, and he says to me, the first words, "You are not going on vacation again." I'm like, what happened? The building caught on fire. So, this building would not be here if it wasn't for Tim. Part of it, he took care of the evacuation and got everyone out the door. I don't know if you remember this, but it was the fourth floor that caught on fire. And so, anyway, Tim took charge. And again, he was truly my right-hand man. He was great. He was dependable. My favorite phrase that he always said to me, in quotes, "Leave it to me." And I knew as a manager, those were my favorite words, because I knew it was going to be taken care of. He would take care of, you know, we would a lot of times get copied on emails, and a lot of times I would wonder, maybe I shouldn't follow up. But he would get a little irritated with me, because I would say, "Hey, Tim, did you take," and then before I even finish, because it's already done. You know, so Tim, you know, he was one who took care of things. Again, just another random memory. Tim did not like my driving. I have an old BMW, and we were late for an event in Pasadena. People in Pasadena, the Pasadena freeway is my favorite freeway. And so if you've ever driven it, it's really fun, especially if you go fast around the curve. He was not very happy when we arrived. And he was actually pretty silent throughout the ride. And so anytime we would have to go somewhere for an event and we would have to drive, he would always drive after that. He'd never let me drive again. But the thing is, okay, when he drove, he drives a Jaguar. I'm not sure why he never turned on the air conditioning. Is that a thing? I don't know. Because we were in suits. I remember this time. We were in suits for the time. And I would give him subtle hints. It's really hot in here. And he never turned on the air conditioning. I remember getting out of the car and it's dripping. But anyway. Okay, for those of you who remember, for those of you who work here, many of you remember the workday implementation. And I know some of you still have battle scars. We do too. But I wanted to share this because Tim really cared so much for the students. And part of the issue is during the implementation, we had a lot of issues where students were not getting paid. And it really broke his heart. And students would often come to his office and pour out their hearts saying that they're not able to pay the rent or when is my paycheck coming? And I remember it was at the end of the day, Tim and I sat down for a meeting, and it was just two of us, and we were just trying to strategize, what can we do? What is something different that we can do? What creative way can we do to get these students paid? And I remember Tim, again, he cared so much, he broke down in tears. We both were crying, and we were just trying to figure out, what can we do? And that's just a testament of how much he really cared for the department and for the students. You're also here, I'm gonna share some other written testimonies, but as Sandy mentioned, Tim knew everyone, it seemed like. We would walk down throughout campus, and he would always say hello to somebody he knew. And even if he didn't see them, we would hear a yell across campus, "Hey, Tim!" You know, he just seemed to know everybody. The other thing I wanted to share is that Tim was there for me. As administrator, you know, we are dealing with problems all the time. And sometimes these problems are overwhelming. And but there are times when I was able to share with Tim and pour out my heart. And he was always there. And he would get formal with me, you know, in his raspy voice. "Oh, Mr. Low, it'll be all right." You know, he would listen, and then he would remind me to keep things in perspective. And just also I wanted to share, even on commencement day, for those of you who are here or will be graduating, out here in our quad, the EE quad, there is, it'll be a lot of people during the commencement reception. And students would come and always seek him out because they always wanted to thank him and to take pictures with him. Really, he was a celebrity here. All right, just some things I just wanted to point out, things that I'm gonna miss. I'm gonna miss saying good morning to him every morning because his office is right next to mine. I'm gonna miss his electric guitar ringtone on his iPhone. I'm gonna miss hearing his son Nick and his grandkids over FaceTime. Because once in a while they'll FaceTime him on his phone and he wouldn't close his doors. But anyway, and also I'm gonna miss those conversations that he would have on the speakerphone. So if you've ever called him, if you ever called him, he wouldn't just pick up the phone, but he would always talk to you via speakerphone. And so I'm gonna miss that. Other thing is I'm gonna miss the rattling of the keys. You know, he handled our keys in our department, and if whenever he was looking for a specific key, he would take the bucket of keys that he would have and pour it on his desk and say, "Do you want the keys?" I'm like, "What are you doing?" But in any case, I'm going to share a few more memories from a few of our other staff members who gave me permission to share. All right, and they don't want to be named, but I'll just read the stories. Tim was like a father to me and many others in EE. He was the voice of wisdom, he had a heart of passion, and he was the sweetest man. We all knew his love for his family. He often shared his children's and grandchildren's achievements, and we felt like we knew them. He took care of us more than we took care of him. We will miss his accent, we will miss his smile, we will miss him dearly. Another snippet is Engineering Graduate Student Association has a yearly soccer tournament, and Tim, Mayumi, and I would go out there and support the EE students. Tim would be very passionate about the game and cheer on the students. He would also yell at the faculty for their foul, for the foul play, and for the referees allowing it. He quickly became the unofficial EE coach And for the first 2 years, the EE students brought home the trophy. I remember when EE first got their bike to use for doing errands. Tim took it out and went across campus. As he was approaching a stop sign, he tried to stop by squeezing the right handlebar, but proceeded through the intersection. He then returned to the office and complained that the bike had no brakes. We had to explain to him that the brakes were in the you just had to pedal backwards. We all had a good laugh, and he just commented back, "American bikes." All right, the last one I have is, it's a little small, I'm gonna read this. Tim did one of the most gracious favors for me when I first started working at EE. He noticed I was always breaking a sweat as I arrived to work in the mornings. He asked me why I was always out of breath, and I told him that I had to park by the credit union building, which is completely on the other side of campus by the 110 freeway. He suddenly became worried that I was walking back alone to my car after 5 p.m., so he immediately picked up the phone and spoke to someone in charge of parking. He rushed me over to Transportation Center, and within less than an hour, I was able to move my car and get a new permit to park in the nearest structure across our office. Even without knowing me, he did me this favor. If you have or would like to, you're more than welcome to come on up to share some memories that you have of Tim. I'm going to go ahead and leave it open, and so just please come on up.
I'm Todd Brun. I'm a professor here in EE Systems. And I don't know that I have a specific memory that I wanted to share. When I think about my interactions with Tim over many years since I've been here, they were mostly very small things. If I described them, they wouldn't seem particularly special. And yet, somehow the sum of that was very special. I have always considered myself very fortunate to work where I do. I'm surrounded by smart and kind people. And in that way, you know, Ken was a smart and a kind man. And yet, he had something more as well. So just a small thing, passing the time of day, chatting about the weather, asking about your vacation. He would ask me, "You doing any plays? What's coming up?" He came and saw some of my plays, which I thought was really going above and beyond. And so it's hard to say, what was it that made him what he was? But I know this, when I heard from Tim that he'd passed away, I felt just the deepest sense of shock and loss, which I still feel. And we've all lost somebody, so I think we're all familiar with this sensation. For a long time afterwards, every now and then the thought comes in your mind, "Oh my God, Tim is gone." And I imagine I'll be having that thought for quite some time. So that's all I wanted to say. Thank you.
I came a little earlier. I didn't know there were so many folks. It's really great to see you. Hello, all of you. It's nice to see you. My name is Marilee Reynolds, and I came to probably this room before it was renovated as a conference room back in 2000, and interviewed for the department business manager role that I had for 6 years before Ted took place when I moved on. And Tim was in the room with several of the staff that are still here to interview me on that day. And maybe a couple times I think I came back. And I had never really been on the USC campus before, besides football games and things like that, but nothing with regard to the academics in any way. I had no idea whether I really thought I was qualified to do this or what the job would be at all. I'd never worked in a place in higher education. But that being said, we got along, and they decided I was going to be the one that was going to take this seat. And Tim did have the office right next to me. And I will say that everyone here just took me under their wings, and we got along great. But Tim, he did. It's that relationship that he had with the students that really explained to me. I didn't really know the details of what it's like to be employed as a graduate student in the PhD programs and how detailed it can get down to these fine little regulations of things. And he trained me, he introduced me to everyone on campus. We worked together to replace staff, taught me about the procedures and this and that. And I think, you know, it was about 2 years into my career there that I ended up with a medical situation that I had to be out for 4 months unexpectedly on a medical leave. And just like overnight, it just happened and things turned out fine, but I came back to work 4 months later. And I want to say Tim and all the rest of the staff, but in particular Tim, we would chat. They kept things going. Not that I kept it all together, but I felt comfortable being able to be away, and then, gosh, when I came back, it was like the most second welcome that I had. It was wonderful. So Tim touched me, and I watched how he had all those interactions with the students. They would come back to visit him. They would remember him. They emailed him. They brought back stories of their travels. They brought back presents to him. They would ask his advice on other things besides just payroll. He had a true relationship with every single person that walked through his door. And I want you to know how many people that I saw in my 6 years sitting next to him, watching come in and out of that office, are the people that he touched. He has touched more people by magnitude than I've ever would touch, even in a big place such as this. And he did it willingly, lovingly, wantingly, always open and accepting of everyone, wherever they came from, whatever they did, who any of us were, and would always help out. And yes, I was very, like Todd, since I didn't see him every day all the time when it came, it was quite a shock because I didn't know that the situation was as severe as it was. And like you, I will be missing him for a long period of time. Thanks.
Hi everyone, I'm the Vice Chair for Administration, Linda Rock, and I'm so glad I was able to make it. I wasn't sure I was going to be here today. Most of the memories have been shared already, but I can give a few different ones. When I first joined 23 years ago or so, I joined the Viterbi Business Affairs Office, which was then EFO, and Tim had left only recently to come to EE Systems, and so he had a really unique perspective. He'd worked on university payroll, he'd worked at the engineering payroll office, and then he'd come to a department to start working in their payroll office. And so while I got a lot of my training from the central payroll and HR and also from my colleagues in EFO, Tim was really a unique contact for me because he sat on both sides He'd been in the main payroll office, so he understood what we were up against there and the deadlines and what needed to be done. But then he'd been spent some time in the department, and he understood those deadlines. And I didn't start in an academic department, so I had to learn through others what that was about. And Tim really helped me understand very early on what went on at the department level, and was kind of an in-house spy for me in some ways of just telling me how we could improve what we did centrally to try to make life easier in the departments. And I would often, especially in the first few years, ask him that kind of advice. One of the things that my then supervisor, Dave Murphy, had asked me to do was try to create less of an us against them mentality that kind of existed when I joined him. So I was always trying to break down those walls, and having somebody who lived on both sides and could speak really knowingly and help me was just invaluable. So he was just wonderful that way. I know that not only did he help everyone in the EE department, but honestly, he would help anyone. There were so many times over the years when we had openings in other departments, and we were trying to get things filled, and payroll deadlines were coming, and all we had to do was just start the conversation of, Tim, would you be able to? And before you could even finish, he's like, sure. What do they need? How can I help? He did payroll for other departments when needed. He trained so many people when we didn't have bandwidth to do that over the years. So his reach is really far. It goes way beyond just EE systems. He has a training reach that spreads into almost all of our departments in one way or the other, and helped on more times than I can even count over the years that we asked him for that kind of help. He was also, as a few have mentioned, he was one of the best connected people on campus that I know. There's a few others, a couple in this room, who they've been here a long time, they've served on lots of different committees, they know everyone. So, and frankly, I'm not that well connected. I mean, I'm in my office all the time doing things, I sit on committees too, but not in the same way. So often, if I actually want to know something's going on, I could pick up the phone and call Tim. Even as recently as, you know, a year ago, and say, I'm hearing this, what are you hearing? And he often had better information than I could get from anybody else. Between what he got from staff assembly and then everybody else that he knew that just shared information with him, he was quite a good source of information. And I also knew that if there was something I wanted people to know, along with memos and emails, which most people don't even read, there were a couple people you could call and say, spread the word on this, and you knew that everyone would know he was one of those people, and I did that over the years too. You know, I knew I'd sent a message about it, but I also knew that most of the time that stuff doesn't get read, that it would be like, Tim, tell everybody, just spread the word that this is happening, and he would do it, and we would have either a great turnout or, you know, people would know what was going on, so that was a wonderful resource. So. He really was, I think, what he embodied the best of the Viterbi staff that we have. He loved what he did. He loved the people he worked with. He served the people he worked with and did it in a loving way, as Marilee mentioned, in a very willing way. He made life easier for everybody that worked with him. I think that's, if you're a staff support person, it's one of the best things that you can do. One of the best takeaways is to me, that's what we're here for. And Tim did it better than most, I think, and for a very long time, and people got to know him, and he just knew generations. I know here, especially with the faculty and the staff, and their children, sometimes their children's children, depending on how long they were here. So he will be missed. This has been a particularly hard couple of years for the school. We've lost a lot of people lately, and Tim is just one on the list that we will miss terribly. But we will remember him well. I know his department will. He will live forever on our website, having won that award, which is nice to know, and all the pictures that are out there on the blogs, and I know in everybody's hearts, and that's how people are remembered. Somebody told me a year ago, and I think it might be a Jewish tradition, but I'm not 100% sure, that there are three deaths. There's the death of the body, there's the death of the mind, but the last death, this makes me cry, is when people stop saying our name out loud. So I think that the more times we mention Tim and Tim Boston and say his name out loud, he will stay alive for all of us. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Bhaskar Krishnamachari. I'm a faculty member here in electrical engineering. I've been here since 2002. And of course, like everyone that works here, have met Tim so many times over little things. Just what's always amazing me is how could a person be so charming, so helpful, just so selfless, and really competent. You know, anytime there was a request for something, a couple of hours later there'd be an email in my box that said, it's done, it's ready. I'm remembering just his voice on his answering machine. You call his number and he goes, EE Tim Boston. And I was just thinking about just how EE came before Tim Boston, just the way he represented all of us. I have this memory of, I think a few times asking him to prepare a letter for me to help me get a visa to go to different countries. And I remember the first time perhaps I asked for this, and he prepared a letter, and he said, you know, ready in your mailbox, and I go pick up this letter in my mailbox, you know, printed, and I had to kind of look at it twice because it wasn't an Arial or Times New Roman, it was this really floral script, and I was a little worried that I took it to this embassy they just rejected right out of hand, but it was just his choice, you know, in that moment. I wanted to share something. So someone mentioned blogs and websites. How many of you know Tim Boston had his own website? He made one in the 90s, apparently, and it was left in this corner of the web unattended for nearly 20 years. So it's still out there. You might be able to find it with some luck. I'm actually going to read you just a little bit of it. It's a single page, and it's a website from the 90s. Like, any of you that have seen what the web looked like in the mid-90s, we just immediately recognize that crazy background, the weird flashing bars. Yeah, it has all of that. So it says, welcome to the world of Tim Boston. Congratulations, you managed to reach the webpage of the Mad Englishman in the Department of Electrical Engineering at USC in Los Angeles. And he talks about, I've been at USC since January 1989 in various positions, culminating in my present position as Assistant Administrator for Electrical Engineering. Before coming to LA, I worked for the Health and Safety Commission in London as Executive Assistant to the Chairman. And you're thinking, like, wow, it's, you know, a whole professional bio. But then immediately pivots to, I'm a fanatical supporter of Coventry City Football Club, who play in the English Premiership and flirt with relegation every year, but not this year. So you'll not be able to perhaps figure out what year this was. He talked about his family briefly there, and then he says, enough about me. USC is one of the most cosmopolitan universities in the US. We have students from every continent except Antarctica. The penguins are just not smart enough. There was an exclamation mark there, followed with, in bold letters, yet, 4 exclamation marks. And then he switches to talking about the Department of Electrical Engineering System has very energetic faculty who love to teach and carry out important research, and kind of ends this page with, the department also has experienced and dedicated staff who take pride in assisting the students in their degree objectives. And I think that was Tim. So thank you.
I'm Nichole Phillips, and I actually was a student worker work study in the Viterbi finance office when Tim actually came over to Viterbi, and I was a poli sci major. So my fondest memory of Tim is I had to do all these long papers and everything, and I thought to myself, well, who better to edit my papers than this Englishman here in the office? And he was always so gracious, and he'd tell me he learned so much from reading my papers, and it helped me. We got A's. All the papers he edited, and I always gave him credit for helping out on those, and I will always appreciate Tim for that. So, and it was a joy working with him. When I actually became staff, and one of the first things I realized I had to do was enter student aid into the system. So Dave Murphy goes, well, here's your access, and I get my access, and I go to the central training, and I come back, and I go, okay, really, what do I do now? And everybody was like, I don't know, go see Tim. So I went and met with Tim, and he gave me the practical use of how to do the system and how to enter the AIDS awards and use it. And that was Tim. You could always go to him for anything, and he gave you the practical solution every time. So,
thank you, everyone, for sharing. I'd like to bring up the family of Minda and Mark, Sarah, if you can come on up, please. I have something for you. And also, we collected cards and memories and pictures and stories, and they're all in this box. And so there is four keychains, USB drives for you to, so you don't have to fight over it, you can go ahead and have your own. So thank you. Tim was so special to us, and we're so happy that you're able to join us and hear all these wonderful stories. And let's see here, what else? And as you had mentioned, as Sarah mentioned, there's Tim's favorite charitable organization is the Phelan McDermott Syndrome Foundation. So if you would like more information, it's not too late to give and to donate. And I have the website if you want it, and we can send it out if you'd like. I also want to send a special thanks to Mayumi and Geraldine for organizing this event. And I know there are others too, Gloria, Gabby, Seth, and Alan, and sorry about forgetting anybody else, but thank you all for assisting with and help putting this event together. Thank you all for coming. We have refreshments outside. It's not raining, so please stay. Grab some refreshments. The room is going to be open. We're going to start up the slideshow again. We'll turn up the sound. I think we've got Tim's favorite music, which is classic rock. So please come in and enjoy, share fellowship, share stories, and hang out for a while. Thank you for coming.
I'm going to go to the next one.